Nothing you and I can do to change who God is. We don't come to God on our terms. This is not a negotiating conference. This is not a God says, well, what, you know, what would you like? Here's what I'd like. Let's come talk about it. He's God. And he's a holy, righteous God. And he's given us the privilege of not just coming and singing about him, but entering into his actual presence. But it starts by recognizing who this God is that invites us in. And the awesome privilege that we have.
In the book of Matthew, chapter 24, the Lord said, there shall rise false Christs and false prophets. People appearing to be like they're on the Lord's side, but they're really not. This verse here says, and they shall teach my people the difference between the holy and profane, and cause them to discern between the unclean and the clean. Lauren Daigle, famous on K-Love and all these radio stations that they got, Christian radio stations. She portrays herself to be Christian, but she's really not. Just like the rest of these celebrity Christians, they cannot answer this one question.
In a recent interview, Grammy and Dove Award winner Lauren Daigle was asked her opinion about homosexuality.
Do you feel that homosexuality is a sin?
You know, I can't honestly answer on that. I have too many people that I love that they are homosexual. I don't know. I can't say one way or the other. I'm not God. So when people ask questions like that, that's what my go-to is. I just say read the Bible and find out for yourself. And when you find out, let me know, because I'm learning too.
The thing about this is people like K-Love and all these mega church pastors that invite her to their place of worship, are they even teaching her anything? Or is she just lying about it so she could keep her fame? That's the thing about this whole homosexual agenda, especially when it comes to so-called Christian leaders. They will not answer it because they'll lose their money, they'll lose their fame, their status, all that. And no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. Therefore, it is no great thing if his ministers also be transformed as the minister of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works. I'm going to go and give her the benefit of the doubt that she doesn't know. But if she does, this is the verse for it right here. And like I said, there's many places where God talks about this. But the main reason why I wanted to bring this video out today is because of this. Lauren Daigle on why she loves Billie Eilish, Anderson .Paak, and Kanye. If you don't know who Lauren Daigle is, this is one of her most played songs on a Christian radio station. Now, this article was published by the Christian Post, I believe. In an interview with Zane Lowe on Apple Music, Daigle ran through her At Home With playlist and explained why, as an artist, she thrives on connecting with people through her music, and discussed Kanye West's newfound faith and singer Billie Eilish. Now, the whole Kanye West thing, I did a video on that earlier. It's probably one of my second videos. You can check that out. But who is Billie Eilish? Let's see. The article goes on. Daigle kicked off her At Home playlist with Kanye West Sunday Service Choir. The rapper is a nominee at the 51st Annual Gospel Music Association Dove Awards, along with Daigle. Another artist featured on Daigle's list of the songs is Billie Eilish, the popular pop star. Eilish, known for her dark theme, music, and style, recently revealed that as a child, she was very religious despite not being raised to believe in God. But now she's neutral and is open to every belief pretty much. Now, this is Billie Eilish, the person that she likes to listen to. This is one of her songs. My Lucifer is lonely, standing there killing time. Can't commit to anything but a crime. Peter's on vacation, an open invitation. Animals, evidence, pearly gates look more like a picket fence. Once you get inside them, got friends but can't invite them. Hills burn in California, my turn to ignore you. Don't say I didn't warn you. All the good girls go to hell, because even God herself has enemies. God herself has enemies. This who she likes listening to? In 2 Corinthians 6:14, it says, "Be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship hath righteousness with unrighteousness? And what communion hath light with darkness?" I know a lot of people are going to be upset and say, not Lauren Daigle, because they love their idols. But this is what she says about Billie Eilish. Daigle talked to Apple Music about Ellis and her music producer, Finesse. "Her ability to sing is awesome. And Finesse, what a hero. That dude is a legend. He is a mastermind, master creator. I have a lot of respect for Finesse and the way he does things. And then the way that they are able to capture air over Billie's vocal, I love it," Daigle told Lowe. So you love a song that goes totally against what you believe in. That is if you actually believe in the Bible. You talking about Lucifer? Man, come on, man.
Because do you call yourself still a Christian artist even in the mainstream, or what do you call yourself?
I feel like those labels get put on you by other people. Well, I was reading an article. I read them like here and there. Gotta stay away sometimes, but then other times I'm like, indulge. And I was reading one, and one of them's like Christian artist, another one's just artist. So I think part of me is just artist because it encompasses everything. That's kind of how I see myself.
It's just like with my last video with Lecrae. These artists are afraid to be labeled as Christian because it doesn't come with the fame. It doesn't come with the riches. If you are a true believer, you're going to see loss. People are going to hate you. People are not going to want you to go to their place of worship because you're speaking so much truth. They hate the truth. "For do I now persuade men or God, or do I seek to please men? For if I yet please men, I should not be the servant of Christ." Christ warned us about all these false prophets, false teachers, false so-called believers. Stay away from them. In the last and evil days, he has warned us. Stick to his word. Stay safe out there. The Lord be with y'all.